How's it guys? My name is Dylan and in this video I want to share how I've set up my A7 III for video. So this is how I've set up my camera. It may not be for everyone, but it's a good beginning point which sets some default values. The two main settings I film in are 4K 24 frames per second and 1080p 120 frames per second for slow motion. I've got those settings configured in the 1 and 2 custom dials. To set up the custom dials, turn to the video setting on the dial. Click menu and let's get to the second screen for the video settings. Make sure your exposure is set to manual exposure. Go down to file format and set this one as XAVC S4K. For the purpose of this tutorial video, I'm leaving it on 1080p, as when I'm screen recording the back of the camera, for some reason it doesn't let me do it if I choose 4K. So you select 4K, but I'll be using 1080p. Go down to record settings and choose 24p. This is the ideal frame rate for shooting general video. Again, a note, if you have selected 4K, you want to choose 24p 100 here. Cool, now go back to your live view screen. We want to set the shutter speed to 1/50th of a second, as that's the closest to a 180 degree shutter angle. I'm not going to go deep into this now, but basically, when you shoot video, this number of your shutter speed should be double or close to double of your frame rate. I'm going to bring the ISO down to the lowest number and then adjust the aperture accordingly to get a correct exposure. Then I want to set my picture profile. I like to use HLG3 and I've set that as picture profile 10. I'll show you my settings, but you can use whichever ones you like best. Because I'm creating a default video setting, I'm going to set my white balance to 5000 as a starting out point, but it would be good to be changing that value each time I'm shooting. Focus area, I mostly use the zone focus, but it really depends on what I'm shooting. Focus mode, I've got it set to continuous focus. And cool, that's a good place to start. So now I want to save these settings to custom one. Press the menu button, go to the camera folder one, and then page three. Browse down to 1/2 memory, and then choose number one. We'll press the round button in the middle of the dial, and now it's been saved. If you twist the dial to number one, those default settings will now be loaded. Cool, so now let's set up number two. So turn it back to video. Browse to the second menu item and page one. Now we'll change the file format to HD. And record settings, we're going to set it to 120 frames per second and 100. Close the menu and go back to the live view. And here we're going to change the shutter speed to 180 degree angle, which will be 1/250th of a second. I'll adjust the aperture again to get a good default value for this scene and make sure the picture profile is the same. And now to save this to custom number two, we'll do the same as last time. So now when you switch between custom number one and two, you've got those two most used settings with the default settings configured just how you like. And another tip is to include that 1/2 memory option in the My Menu setting, so that you can access it quickly when you need to change the default settings for different scenes. So in this case, if I wanted to change the white balance setting, I can change it and then quickly resave it. Cool, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Hope it was useful to someone and I'll check you guys in the next video.